Hello everyone, welcome to series of theory of computation. In this video we are discussing introduction and motivation to context free grammar. Grammar is set of rules to construct valid sentence. Like our general language, that is in English, there are various rules through which we can create or make sentences for communication. In the same way, in theory of computation, language, that is collection of strings, is made up of certain rules that we call it as a context-free grammar. Grammar is a set of rules that generates syntactically correct sentence for particular language. So this is in general, for any communication we need some grammar to make syntactically correct sentences. Now this context-free grammar consists of four tuples, that is V, T, P and S. Here V stands for finite set of variables. We call it as non-terminals, and these non-terminals are always represented with the help of capital letters. Then next is T. T stands for finite set of terminals. Terminals are also called as end symbols, and these are represented with small letters. That is, after replacing this non-terminals with terminal, there is no further replacement possible. We can see this with the help of examples later on. Then next is P. P is a set of rules, or we can say grammar rules or production rules or substitution rules. And the format of this P is alpha tends to beta, where this alpha is only one variable. That is, you can have only one variable at LHS to replace, and at RHS there can be one or more variables possible, and it can be a combination of terminals, non-terminals or both. So this is about production rule, and S stands for start symbol. So this is a basic definition, formal definition of context-free grammar consisting of V, T, P, S. V stands for non-terminals, T stands for set of terminals, P stands for production rule, and S stands for start symbol. Now we will discuss one example of context-free grammar. Here S gives 0 A, A gives A 0 or 0. So these are the production rules. S is a start symbol, then non-terminal is A, and terminal symbol is 0. This is a grammar. Now we will discuss what kind of strings or language will be generated with the help of these grammars. So suppose initially we have S tends to 0A. In the next stage, in next step, we can replace this A with 0. So the string that we are getting is 00. Again, in another way, first of all, S gives 0A, so we can replace this A with A0, because we have such rule, A can be replaced with A0. So I have put A0 here, and in next step, either A can be replaced with A0 or 0. So I have replaced here A with 0. So I am getting a string 000. In the next way, suppose we are starting with our starting production, S gives 0A. Here A will be replaced with A0. Again we are replacing A with A0, and finally we are putting 0 at the place of A. So we are getting a string 0000. So the kind of language generated by this grammar is giving 00, 000, 0000, and so on. So these are the strings generated by this grammar. This is how you can generate different strings from the given grammar. Now we will discuss one more example. Here another grammar is given. S gives 0s1 or epsilon. Epsilon is a null symbol. That is, it is nothing you have to put at the place of epsilon. Now we will see what kind of language will be generated with the help of this grammar. So first of all, suppose S gives 0s1. Now in the next iteration, I can put that 0s1 and 1. So here S is replaced with 0s1. Again in next iteration, I can put 00. Now S have two possibilities to replace, that is 0s or epsilon. So I have put epsilon. If I am putting epsilon, it will be nothing. So 0011, this kind of string will be generated with the help of this language. Okay, now next is, again I will try to generate some another string. S gives 0s1. Again I will replace this S with 0s1. Now again I will try to replace this S with जीरो 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 एस वन जीरो सॉरी वन एंड वन एंड एट द एंड आई विल रिप्लेस दिस एस विद एप्सिलॉन दैट इज नथिंग सो आई विल गिव जीरो 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 वन वन वन. This is a string generated by this grammar. Next is again simply if I have I can put s give 0 s 1 and at the place of s I can put epsilon. So if you see the pattern of strings that we are getting number of zeros same number of zeros followed by same number of ones. That is here 1 0 is there, 1 1 is there, here 2 0 is there, two ones are there, here three zeros are there, three ones are there. That is, we are getting a string of pattern 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. So the language generated by this context free grammar is 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n. This is how we have to generate the language from the grammar. Some another kind of questions may be asked in the exam, that is you are provided with some language and you have to generate a grammar for that language. So this is about the context-free grammar. I hope you understand the concept. Thank you for watching and don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel to see more videos on this topic.